Hello. I have a question. Does anybody know why there are no gas stations on the intersections of the 401 or where it turns into the I-40, the Auto 40 in Quebec? In the United States, at every intersection, there's generally a little cluster of gas stations and hotels and restaurants as you go down the interstate. But in Canada, there's no such thing. There are places called en route, which are service stations. Those are available, but they are not, you're not exiting, you're just pulling off into those places. It's a rest area, a service center. But when you come to an overpass or an exit, there aren't any. I mean, you would go into the town that's there, and then there would be things. And there would be signs that say what's available, I think. But they aren't right at the intersections like they are in the United States. Does anybody know why? Is it prohibited? Know that things have to be so far away? Because it's very country. You know, you go along these, and there are, it is not imposed upon by civilization. It's all very rural and forests, sometimes fields. It's not like it is down there, and I'm curious just why. Sometimes I felt, when I used to come to Canada from the United States, I felt quite lost on them, that there was no place to, you know, those service stations are very far apart. Anyway, just thought I'd ask. Bye. Hello, it's Nancy today. Well, I'm driving in Quebec. I'm going to the temple in Montreal. It's only 2 hours from Ottawa or something like that. So I thought it would be a good idea. So I was going to tell you what I know, which is very little, about driving in Quebec. I know that Quebec drivers drive differently than other drivers. For instance, the car ahead of me pulled in as soon as he was past my bumper. I don't know if that's everybody in Quebec does that, but when I took driver's ed, they taught me that you don't do it that way, that you wait until you can see them in your rearview mirror. Anyway, okay, another thing that I have learned through hard experience, these yellow emblems on the green signs, those yellow things have a point. It's either on the left side or the right side, and it points to the direction that your exit will be. Now, that's not too important when you're out in the main stretches out in the country between towns, because it's obvious that you're going to be exiting off to the right. But when you're in the city on 20, those signs are extremely important because you have exits on either side. And the direction that that yellow points is the direction that's going to exit. And you don't get a new lane that appears and exits. The two-lane highway exit. One of them will split off. So if you're not in the right lane, you are now off the road. And I guess a new lane comes afterwards because it's a two-lane highway again. But you have to be very careful that you understand those yellow points. That is what I learned, which is about all I know about driving in Montreal. Hopefully, as I go to the temple, I hope to go every Friday, but as I go, when I can, I hope that it becomes more, that I become familiar with the route, like I finally did with the route to the Atlanta temple. So in the end, I didn't need to have the GPS. I knew the route. That's very important, especially in a town like Montreal, because the driving is very intense. Intense is a good word. See how they've pushed the snow off the road? They've made these holes in the snowbank for the water to run away during the recent thaw. Okay, bye.
Well, it appears that it's snowing ahead. I'm on the island of Montreal. And as you can see, there's now snow here. We had not counted on snow. -13 Celsius, so the temperature is warmer than it was in Ottawa. Or maybe it's the same, but it's a different time of day now. I think it was -15 when we left our house. According to my GPS, the left lane is going to exit in 5 kilometers, and I want to stay with Autoroute 40. I like this new GPS. It's a new Garmin. Point Champlain. I think I crossed the Champlain Bridge. Lane is going to exit in 1 kilometer. I guess those signs are for the other lanes over there. Oh, here we go. Traffic going to merge now. Remember, people could pull in at any moment. But they didn't. They're gone again. Okay, we're still driving in Quebec. I mean in Montreal, which is in Quebec. We're about to take the tunnel La Fontaine, Operation Glacon. Glacon, what is that? It means ice? Glacons? I don't know. I don't want to exit on Sherlock, though, and this has that yellow thing on it. Better get over. Montreal Center. I go 5.8 kilometers before I am going to exit. I'm glad the snow is not sticking. It's nice and dry snow and dry frozen roads, so that the snow is just blowing in there and not causing any trouble. Sometimes it's nice to look at the pattern that the snow makes on the road, but sometimes the road is more important than the snow on it. So we're coming up to the edge of the island, and we're going to come off of the island through the tunnel, the bridge tunnel. H-I-V-E-R, H-apostrophe-I-V-E-R, that's winter, right? Glacone. Isn't that like ice cream? Is it glass? Glacé, isn't it? I'm out of windshield fluid. Maybe it's summer fluid. Which is going to go under the tunnel. And then I believe as soon as I get out from under the tunnel, I turn. Immediately. I don't know if you noticed, but all the road signs are in French. So if you don't speak French, you're at a total disadvantage. Standing clause in the Constitution about Quebec, which has caused a whole lot of grief for many people that are not Quebecers. One thing is the language law, which it's not the standing clause they brought into effect, or they called into play to cover the no English signage unless French is more prominent on the sign. My light is not on for no windshield washer fluid. Okay, I stay here for 3.4 kilometers. And then I take exit 90. Ile Chaton National Park. La Prairie and USA. Ooh, look at that ice down there. It's all broken up. Okay, and 450, I turn to the right. Last time I came to Quebec, to the temple, I don't think I have my GPS. See how important it is to have one if you don't know the way. Looking at all these things on a piece of paper is not easy. This is a very, if you miss this exit that I took to get out when we first got off of the bridge, it's very hard to make it up again. Darn it, I've done it wrong. Darn it. Now it's gotta tell me what to do again. Okay, well, well, I'm telling about how hard it is to fix it if you do it wrong. I do it wrong. But I did the first part right. Going the right way. Going to the Montreal Temple. I'm in Montreal. Actually, I'm in Longueuil. Was in Montreal, but I've crossed out of it now. Took the wrong road when I got off the bridge. First, I took the right road at the first, but the second half on that same circle out of there. Thank you. Victorine or something like that. I think it's up this way, but I'm not sure. I might have to go and turn back the other way.